look like a funny guy.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi, I am Chami Joshi. I'm here with my friends. Yeah.
Yep.
Today we're gonna talk about fashion, style, and swag at large. Fashion is a very what's in wala thing, and style is a more permanent. Okay, oh, this is your style and this is in fashion. I want to know, ki like tum sabke liye, what would you choose? Would you choose fashion or would you choose style over fashion?
I think I would choose style. Fashion like badalta rehta hai. And generally, like, my style has not been exactly what is fashionable. It's inherently me. So like people just like it because it's very me. Like I'm not trying to look good. Like I'm just dressing up and it happens to be very me.
Come fashion.
Fashion and style is the same thing for me.
My style makes the fashion actually.
Your words, not mine. But I feel like subconsciously ho jata hai, where like even in our style we try to incorporate things that are in fashion so that it like elevates our style.
Yeah, yeah. Same, I think for me also. I'm just finding my way into like finding my style in that sense, and it's changed over the last few years also. Like there's been phases where I've worn like Indian clothes and all of that. I do add like elements of fashion, but I would always choose style over fashion because I work so hard to get to a point where I'm comfortable in wearing what I want to wear and like not giving a fuck about what's in or like what people would want to see me in or expect to see me in more than like want to see me in or whatever.
What about you?
I think I would choose fashion because like my style has changed a lot since I like came out as trans as well, because you know I used to dress up in a certain way just to fit into the section of being a man. But when I discovered that, you know, fashion is very fluid. You can wear anything you want and you can be, you know, just yourself, wearing a skirt, wearing a pants or whatever. So experiment with as much as I can just to find who, where I belong or what truly resonates with me. So it's like, you know, fashion immediately.
Do you find it like more comforting?
Yeah, it's more comforting just because of my dysphoria as well, because I even used to wear skirts because I felt very dysphoric. But as soon as I figured that this shit is just a piece of fabric and it's not related to any gender and stuff, so it was like more, you know, revolutionary and like more close to me as well. So yeah, I love that.
And how has your style changed since, matlab, like what are you wearing right now? Going back to your Instagram where I can see like, you know, Indian clothing.
Yeah.
So how would you, I mean, what are the common elements that are like in your style but have, you know, like you've
So I think it's mostly like the common elements would mostly be like colors. Like I like wearing colors. I'm not the kind of person who wants to wear just like white or black and stuff like that. I want to be like seen, and I and like most of the time that I'm popular right now, you know, like it's me up. I think like we said, like it's a lot to do with how I express myself and what makes me feel comfortable in my identity. What has helped me reach that point and like keep experimenting with that is also the kind of people I've had around me who affirm my like identity, who affirm my like what I want to do and how I want to express myself.
I think for me, I wouldn't say that I have had like a style in particular. I think I also think in a very like economical way, and like now that I have to be in front of like, you know, the camera, I have to look a certain way, presentable. And a lot of people like hate on me for killing tumhare baal aise ho rahe hain, wo wo kar lo types. So like
they wish like I don't have it.
Yeah.
Check out that. Hater, check out that.
The whole क्या बोलते हैं लाइक कंफर्ट एंड स्टाइल वाला थिंग ऑल्सो आई ऑलवेज लाइक कंफर्टेबल क्लोथिंग बट मोस्ट ऑफ इट इज आई मीन मोस्ट ऑफ इट इज लाइक सुपर एक्सपेंसिव इफ इट हैज टू लुक गुड कंफर्ट तो मतलब सरोजनी के कपड़े में भी आ सकते हैं बट लाइक आई वोंट से दैट आई फाउंड माई स्टाइल एट ऑल बट आई डोंट रियली फक विद फैशन इट्स मतलब ठीक है कूल इट्स गोइंग यहाँ पे चल रहा है बढ़िया मेरे साथ ऐसा सीन है कि लाइक अच्छा अभी कोई शो पॉपुलर है तो मुझे अभी नहीं देखना
अच्छा अच्छा अच्छा
आई विल वॉच इट लाइक व्हेन you know, maybe like 3 months later.
It's very overwhelming when everyone loves it so much. You're like, am I supposed to love this?
I just want to add to like Chavi's point, like, I also like used to think about economic point of view. Obviously that is a major factor, but I've also like started thinking about like how it would impact other things and how many times I can wear the clothes also. Like that's become really important to me now.
How many like outfits can this top go
with?
If you go to like my profile, you should check it. Half of the outfits that I've created is just things that are in the house that I take and make it into my style. Like it's not this is my style and I'm wearing it. Like I make it into, and that becomes my style. Like
I mean the whole DIY jugaad thing has only come up recently. Huh. They're like, oh I can do that. Like, oh cool, like everybody's doing it, that's pretty cool.
I've been
doing
it
for you. She didn't let you know. She invented it.
What do you think about like thrift stores in general?
You can like start a thrift store, but don't make sustainability like a major fact selling point of a thrift store if it's not sustainable. Even big brands do that. They use sustainability to push their shit forward.
H&M is doing it away.
Exactly. And
then how dare H&M is my point. How can you push
it?
Yeah.
If my time is sustainable brands, please. My problem with thrift stores is the sizing. That's also my problem with like clothing in general. I'm massive. Thrift stores especially also, they barely cater to other sizes apart from the standard like good body type or whatever. I do like some of the thrift stores are doing some really great like curation stuff, like actual hand picking things and curating things.
And the prices are like thick, it makes sense, you know?
Yeah.
Don't the parcels smell really good?
Yeah.
I don't know how they do it, but like a...
I really don't thrift because I think like I buy style wear, I can only get it from a certain place like H&M and Zara and like big companies. Thrifting is like really necessary right now just to like, you know, cycle things and...
Upcycling is good, like that is actually good.
But you know what, apart from thrift stores, I'm really excited about these like little like collectives or like just like young creative people starting their own sort of ventures where they're like making like polymer things, like my friend made me this ring and like my juniors are making like little cute little like indie kind of things, like necklaces out of like paper clips and stuff. Play rings are so cute, like frogs, I'm obsessed with that.
Dude,
same. I'm obsessed, I saw your video and I fucking love frogs. So like stuff like that I'm obsessed with, like fully charge me for your craft, like go ahead. A lot of them are not claiming to be sustainable, and that's fine by me. Like if you're not sustainable, don't claim it like fully. But yeah, like I'm loving that sort of like bringing their aesthetic to other people so other people can also enjoy it. Why that's happening all over Instagram right now.
What, according to all of you, are like the staples that people should have? Actually, like a white shirt, like what about you?
For me, at least.
That's actually quite nice. Yeah.
I think boots just kind of go with like everything.
What kind?
Just black boots, like combat.
Like knee-high,
Sneakers. I was just gonna say, like Vans, like Converse, these things just kind of go with
everything.
Can go with anything.
And having the combination of black and white, you can like do so much with black and white. It's a necessary thing.
I think it's just having that one sort of like statement piece or something that you stick to for a while. Like for me now, it's this chain that I have with my friends. I love it. I want to get more. For a while, it was rings. Before that, a little before that, it was just dupattas and like scarves and stoles that I used to carry everywhere. No matter where I went, I used to have like a, even with like non-Indian clothes or whatever, I used to just carry a dupatta and it was a vibe. Just have fun with your things. It's like that's the essential part of it.
Mango ki ek to cream pants, black pants.
I've been in black pants
as well. Like,
yeah, that
would be like cigarette trousers,
Let's just start then.
Should we
like cut?
Yeah, and then
cut.
Ooh, bar cooked another one.